Hello, Year Nine. It's Mrs. Lloyd here. I hope I find you all very, very well and that you are ready for some English. Yay! Okay, so we've just finished Romeo and Juliet, which was a little bit hurried, but I think you got the good bits, and hopefully you'll be ready for Macbeth in Year 10. Now, what we're going to do now is we're going to sort of come somewhere in between modern day and Shakespeare, and we're going to go for pre-20th century texts. Now, the reason we're doing this is that you do a little bit of pre-20th century prose in literature and non-fiction in the language. So that's what we're going to do. We are going to look at fiction to prepare you for Jekyll and Hyde, a little bit of Gothic for you, that'll be a bit later on. And then we are going to look at the non-fiction, which is what we're going to do now. So this is what you have to do for this. We look at non-fiction and we start with some Victorian stuff, and then we compare it with some modern stuff. Okay? Now that is pretty much what Paper 2 language is all about. All right? So it is important we get those skills correct. And so this is what we're going to compare. We're going to look at nursing predominantly. You'll see there is Florence Nightingale over there, and definitely not an actress over there pretending to be a nurse. Okay, now the resources are attached to Show My Homework. Okay, but I am going to talk you through them in a minute. So, we're going to have a look at the first type of question instead of going to the text straight away. You know how to read two texts, okay? Read the questions first because then you can know what you're looking for as you're reading the text. The first type of question is really quite easy. Well, I say it's easy, there are things that can go wrong. All you've got to do is to find out which are true. Now, they might sneak some things in there that you're not expecting, so be careful. Reading question is very important, and reading the text is very important too. Then you've got two which are slightly higher marks, as you can see. One of them is to do with source B, and the other one is to do with both. Now, the first one there you can see is about analysing language. Now, we're very good at this, all right? We know how to analyse language, but for the most part, we have analysed language from fiction texts. Now we're going to do it for non-fiction text. So what I'm going to ask you to do for those 12 marks is first of all extract for me three times that you think the language is conveying the opinion about the state of the NHS. How are they doing it? Are they using persuasive language? Are they using statistics, emotive language, people quoting, that sort of thing? You know what makes persuasive language. We will be doing some more on that a bit later on. So I need you to pick out three, and then I want you to write a paragraph on your favourite one, the one that you think is going to give you the best paragraph, because that's the one I want to be looking at when you've finished. Now, you've then got a second one, which is about comparison. Now, again, we've done comparison before, but this time we're making a comparison of non-fiction. Compare how the writers convey their attitudes to nursing. So they're going to be different. And as you can see, there are two things that you should be looking for. So therefore, I want two paragraphs, comparative paragraphs. The first one is, what are their differing or similar attitudes? You've got to find evidence from the text about how their attitudes are either similar or different. Then, what methods do they use? Do they talk about nursing in the same way? Do they both use the same kind of emotive language or statistics or anecdotes and so on? And I want two chunky paragraphs about that as well. Okay. Now, it shouldn't take you more than maybe an hour, potentially maybe an hour and a half, but what I want from you is for you to upload your favourite language paragraph from question two, and then your favourite comparative paragraph for question three. I want you to give me the best ones that you do, Okay, so you are extracting three pieces of language for question two and writing me a paragraph that I want to have a look at. And then you're writing two paragraphs for question three, which are comparative, and I'd like to see your best one, please. And like those both uploaded on Friday on Show My Homework, please. Okay, so have a go, see how you get on, take your time reading, and then if there's any questions, I'm going to be on Show My Homework having a quick peek to see if anyone needs me. Good luck.